Hello students, today we are going to study about another topic of your chapter Optical Instruments, that is Compound Microscope. And the objective of today's topic is to study about construction and working of compound microscope. So today's topic is Compound Microscope. What is Compound Microscope? A compound microscope is an optical instrument used for observing highly magnified images of tiny objects. Let's see the construction of compound microscope. A compound microscope consists of two converging lenses, an objective lens O', this one, of very small focal length and short aperture, and an eyepiece, this one, of moderate focal length and large aperture. The two lenses are held coaxially at the free ends of the tube. So these two lenses are coaxially, means their centers are same, at a suitable fixed distance from each other. The distance of objective lens from the object can be adjusted by rack and pinion arrangement. So you can adjust the distance of objective lens from the object. Now let's see it's working. So this is the ray diagram of a compound microscope. OB is the object is placed just beyond the focus of objective. F naught is the focus of objective lens. F naught is also focal length of objective lens, FE, and in this side it is also FE, which is the focal length of objective lens. It is eyepiece and this is objective or object lens. The object OB is placed just beyond the focus of objective, which forms real inverted and magnified image. This is the image which is formed by objective lens O'. This image is formed within the focus of eyepiece. So this is adjusted in such a way that image is formed by objective is between eyepiece and focal length of eyepiece. This is IM, which produces a virtual erected magnified image. So we know that property of convex lenses, that when object is placed between focal length and lens, image will be highly magnified, virtual and erect. So this IM image will act as an object for eyepiece. So the final image I1M1, this one, is adjusted to be formed at the least distance of distinct vision. The eyepiece act as a magnifier or simple microscope. So this part will work as a simple microscope. So what is magnifying power or angular magnification? The magnifying power M of a compound microscope is defined as the ratio of angle beta subtended by the eye by the final image at the least distance vision D to the angle alpha subtended at the eye by object at the same distance D. So this is the formula for angular magnification or magnifying power of compound microscope, that M is equal to beta upon alpha. Now let's see what is the magnification of compound microscope for normal adjustment. Normal adjustment means image will be formed at D, which is least distance of distinct vision. Okay, let's see here the diagram again. Remember students, for small angles, means when theta is very small, you can take alpha equal to tan alpha and beta is equal to tan beta. But we also know that tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base. So using that relation, we get here tan alpha is equal to OB upon D. This is OB upon D, as it is the distance of the object at least distance of distinct vision. Similarly for tan beta, it is I1 M1 divided by D. But also we know that magnification is equal to beta upon alpha. As beta is equal to tan beta and alpha is equal to tan alpha, we can write beta is equal to tan beta divided by tan alpha. Putting the value of tan alpha and tan beta in this equation, we get d and d will get cancelled and we are left with I1 M1 divided by OB. Now we can also write this equation as by multiplying and divide by IM. Okay, so we are dividing and multiplying by IM, where IM is the height of the intermediate image, this one. Okay, so we are going to divide and multiply this equation by IM. Now what is the reason? Let's see. So from the objective we know, so this is the distance of objective of the image. So this is the distance of image from the objective. Then the linear magnification of the objective, M0. We know that linear magnification is equal to V0 upon U0. And here V0 is IM and U0 is OB. Similarly, the IPC is a magnifier. The linear magnification of IPC is ME, which work like a simple microscope, which is equal to I1 M1 divided by IM, which is equal to 1 plus d upon fa. This equation you have already proved in simple microscope. So from there we are, so from there we get this equation. Now the magnifying power of compound microscope, we have two lenses, one is objective and second is eyepiece. Therefore the combined magnifying power is equal to I1 M1 divided by IM multiplied by IM divided by OB, which is equal to ME multiplied by M0, where ME is the magnification of eyepiece and M0 is magnification of objective. So this is the combined magnifying power of compound microscope. Let's see the exact value. So overall magnifying power of compound microscope is the product of magnification produced by objective and the magnification produced by eyepiece. So multiplying M0 and ME, we have put the value of M0, this is value of M0, so this is value of M0, and 1 plus D upon Fe is the value of ME. So this is one of the relation for magnifying power of compound microscope. So now we are going to get relation in terms of focal length and length of the microscope. For that, what we have to do, we use the lens equation, which is 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Now apply Cartesian sign conventions. U0 is negative because it is on the left hand side and V0 is positive as the image is on right hand side. After putting all this value, we get V0 upon U0 is equal to V0 upon F0 minus 1. So we know that M is equal to V0 upon U0, 1 plus D upon Fe. In place of V0 upon U0, we are going to use this value. So we get magnification is equal to V0 upon F0 minus 1 into 1 plus D divided by Fe. If object is kept very close to principal focus of objective, so U0 is nearly equal to F0. So if we are going to place object very close to the objective lens, then its distance will be equivalent to F0. The focal length of eyepiece is very small, so V0 is nearly equal to the distance between the object and the eyepiece. We can take this value as a L, which is also called length of the microscope. So now we in place of U0, so now in place of U0 we are going to put F0, and in place of V0 we are going to put L, which is length of the microscope. So after putting all these values, we get M is equal to V0 upon U0, V plus D upon Fe. In place of V0 we have put capital L, which is length of microscope, and U0 is equal to F0. So consider here F0 and Fe are small, but always remember Fe is greater than F0. and L is called optical length of the microscope. So this is the magnification of compound microscope in case of normal adjustment, means when image is formed at D. Second case is, okay, here is some points which you should know, that the magnifying power depends upon focal length from this equation. So from the last equation we get that the magnifying power of a compound microscope depends upon the focal length of objective and the eyepiece. M is large if F naught and FE are small. It means least the value of focal length of eyepiece and objective, more will be the magnification. Secondly, when the object is kept very close to first focus of the objective, means the distance between object and this objective lens would be small. Okay, second case is when final image is at infinity. So this is another adjustment when final image will be formed at infinity. So you can see here no image is going to be formed, image will be formed at infinity. So what are the changes in that case? If the image formed at infinity, then we can neglect one from the previous equation. Like we got the equation M is equal to V naught upon U naught, 1 plus D divided by FE. From there we can neglect the 1 and we left with magnification is equal to V naught upon U naught D upon FE. Or again, in place of V naught, if we are going to put capital L, which is length of microscope, and in place of U naught we are going to put F naught, which is focal length of objective. So this is the relationship between focal length and length of the microscope with the magnification or magnifying power of the microscope in case of when image formed is at infinity. Now let's see some discussion of the whole topic. Number one, the magnifying power of compound microscope is negative. This is one more important thing. Remember, magnifying power of compound microscope is negative, which means that the image seen in a microscope is always inverted. Number two, for large magnifying power, F naught and FE both have to be small. And the third point is, aperture of both the lenses is small, which minimizes the spherical aberration. So this is all about the compound microscope. Let's see one example. The focal length of the objective and the eyepiece of a compound microscope are 4 cm and 6 cm respectively. If an object is placed at a distance of 6 cm from the objective, what is the magnification produced by the microscope? What is the magnification produced by the microscope? Distance of distinct vision is 25 cm. So we are given with the focal length of objective and eyepiece, also distance of object from the objective and the value of D. Let's try to solve this. F naught means focal length of objective, U naught distance of object from the objective, and FE is the focal length of eyepiece. So we have to find magnification produced by the microscope. That is M, but to calculate M, we should also know about the V naught. So first of all, we are going to find V naught. Let's see the solution. By using Lenz formula, that is 1 by F naught is equal to 1 by V naught minus 1 by U naught. V naught is equal to U naught F naught divided by U naught plus F naught. By putting the value of U naught and F naught in this equation, we get V naught is equal to 12 cm. Now we can put this value to find the magnification. Okay, magnifying power is equal to V naught divided by U naught 1 plus D upon FE. So V naught value is 12 cm minus 6, 1 plus D value is 25 divided by 6. So after solving it out, we get magnifying power is equal to minus 10.33 cm. The negative sign here shows that the final image formed is inverted with respect to object. That's the end of the topic. Thank you.